Okay, let's give a Huffman code for a fairly small alphabet. Let us see about translating a message from the to the encoded message, and then from the encoded message back to the original message. So let me create a message that uses the high frequency letters a lot and the low frequency letters not very often. That is, this message will more or less cooperate with the frequencies that we've discovered from other sources. So let's go ahead and make a short message of just 5 characters long. So, and we'll use the high frequency letters often. Okay. So there's my nice short message. All right, now, I see I don't have uncompressed encoding here, so let me just make one here. So this is an uncompressed code right there. Okay, so if I want to put this message into a Huffman code in order to transmit it, I can either look here, here is my code book, or I can look over here, which is just another representation of the code book, the binary tree that was created following the greedy algorithm for creating the Huffman code. So the first char that I want to transmit is the A, and we see that's a 0. Next char is an A. So when I started the root and head for the A, I see that'll be a 0. Then I have an F. An F is 10111. And then a B. B is 11. And the A is 0. Okay, so that's with the Huffman code that I've created here. The uncompressed version of the code has A is 101. A is 101. F is 000. Let's see, B is 10. Here's B. This is what I'm trying to encode right now. B is 100. And A is 101. So this is the uncompressed. Okay, and I can see in the Huffman code, let's see how many bits am I using here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 bits. So, and I have 5 chars, so the average number of bits per character is 2. For this particular message, the average number of bits per character is 2 bits per character. 2 bits per character. Definitely out of room here. For the same message where I use an uncompressed coding, 3 bits per character, so I will have 15 bits altogether. So that gives me clearly 3 bits per character. So clearly the Huffman code, when my message reflects the frequency that I'm expecting, does give us some compression, 10 bits versus 15 bits. Let's use a message where I don't have that correspondence with the expected compression. So I'll do another 5 bits, but really low frequency letters. So F-E-D... F-E-D, all very low frequency letters. Okay, so the Huffman for F is 10111, for E is 10110, for the D is 1010, F, this F right here, 10111, E is 10110, and D is 1010. Okay, again, this is the Huffman, and I have, well, I need to count up all my bits here. 1, 2, 3, let's mark them every 5. Let's see, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 23 bits. So that's 23 divided by 5 bits per character, which is almost, well, it's between 4 and 5 bits per character, clearly a lot more than the 2 bits per character that I had for a cooperative message up there. Oh, that's 23 divided by 6, excuse me. So that is just under 4 bits per character. Okay, let us encode this then using the uncompressed code, so the F is 000. 000. E is 001. D is 010. 000. 001. And 100. Okay, so I have here 18 bits. And 18 divided by 6 is 3 bits per character, which of course is what I expect to have right there. Okay, so that we can see here that if the message that I'm sending does exhibit the proper and expected frequency characteristics, I can get pretty significant compression. If the message that I'm sending does not exhibit the frequency characteristics I desire, then I will actually not get compression. Things will get worse. So I go from 4 bits per character to from 3 bits per character to almost 4 bits per character. One more thing before I leave this page, and that is I'd like to just make sure that we can actually decode the message properly. The uncompressed is pretty straightforward, right? I just take my message that I receive and divide it up into 3-bit chunks, and then I look up each 3-bit chunk right here on my code book, and that'll give me my F. Now, the thing about that'll give me the character that I'm looking for, right? 000 corresponds to F. And this 000 over here, because I've got 3-bit chunks, there's no question about where to make the division. So this 300 will correspond to F, and this 001 will correspond to 001 is an E. Okay, the Huffman code is different. I can't divide it into chunks like that. I had the length of the encoded characters is variable depending on, you know, how I got it out of the tree. So I would like to make sure that I can decode the message and I'm not going to have any confusion in decoding. So let me use this message right here to start with, okay? So what I do for this, I can either use the codebook again or the tree, whichever is more convenient for me. I start reading the first letter right here, the first bit right here, and I find that in my codebook, and as soon as I see a 0, I have got a match with my letter A, so I know that I'm done here. Now, correspondingly, I can start at the root of the tree, and the 0 says to go to the left, and I'm at a leaf right here. Right here. So that means I am done decoding that letter. So this letter right here stops at this point and I have the letter A. Oops, it looks like I'm okay. All right, so now my next letter right here is again the 0. So in my code book, when I hit the 0, I know I'm done. The 0 says I'm done. My tree 0 brings me to a leaf. So that'll give me my letter A. Okay, now I have start here at this 1. Let's look at the tree first. I go 1, 0, so that's 1, and then 0, so I'm right here, and then 1, that's this 1, so I'm here, and then 1 right to here, and then 1 right to here, right? It's 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, and I'm at a leaf, okay, and the leaf is F, which is correct. Let's do it here. I have a 1, okay, so it could be any of these right here. I have a 0, which eliminates the B, but it could be any of these. All right, I have a 1, which eliminates the C, but I could still have any of these. I have a 1, which doesn't eliminate anything, and then I have a 1, which matches up with my F. So there's my F right there. Okay, and then here I start with a 1 and a 1, and I'm at a leaf right there. So that gives me a B. Okay, so let me do it in the code book. So I start with a 1, eliminating the A. It could be any of these, and then a 1, and that matches with the B. So there's my B right there. And then I start again at the top of the tree. 0 gives me an A. Okay, now we can see an important property that I have to have right here, and that is this has to be a prefix code. In other words, as I'm in the process of decoding this, and I reach a point where I've got a letter, I reach a point where I've got a letter in my code book or a leaf in my tree, I can't accept another bit for another possible letter. In other words, an illegal possible code to have in here would be 1001, right? If I were to add 1001 here for the D, for instance. If I got in my code and I'm starting here, this is the point, I have 100, I could be here, but I could also be at this point right here for my D. And that is not allowed. You must have a prefix code. Must have a prefix code.